very warm welcome to Daily Dispatch powered by HSBC. I have with me the very interesting panel, and we're going to be talking about the hottest topic these days with the surge of Omicron playing out. Of course, it's been a huge challenge for mankind across the world. And especially one thing that's been spoken about the maximum these days has been self-test kits, because these are very high in demand considering the number of people getting infected these days. We have with us a very power-packed panel. We have with us Hasmukh Rawal, who's joining us from MyLabs, the company that's making these self-test kits. And we have with us Mr. J.S. Shinde, who is actually heading the All India Chemists and Druggists Association. So he's going to tell us a little bit about how it's panning out from the chemist's point of view. So let me begin with you, Mr. Rawal, to talk to you a little bit about, 5 lakh test kits sold in just a week. Tell us a little bit about how this is shaping up for MyLabs per se.
Yeah, so there is an immediate surge in the demand of the self-testing kit. And it is a proud moment for us to be there, available in service to the people when they need it most. Giving power of testing to the people is very important tool. And we have seen this in Western world as well. Every government has shifted on self-testing more and more. So yes, it is a good movement for a company like us, where we are always innovating, and it gives us more inspiration to do more. And I think we are all are thinking, what next, what more we can help the citizen of a country to fight the pandemic.
Right. I'm going to come to you, Mr. Rawal. But Mr. Shinde, I want to talk to you a little bit about, from the chemist point of view, a lot of these self-test kits are out of stock in many of the chemists all over the country. Tell us a little bit about how it's shaping up from the chemist point of view.
See, we find in the third wave or anywhere, when because of, the testing delay by path lab and nothing, or because of mobile, or because of awareness, then TV, this thing, a lot of demand for this kit now. And after, particularly, we have seen third wave, there is a lot of demand from consumer for this testing kit.
Mr. Rawal, I want to talk a little bit about the accuracy of these tests. There have been a lot of reports back and forth regarding, whether home test kits are accurate. What about reporting these tests? Because I think when we spoke last, you were also speaking about a reporting mechanism where you feed in the details on the app and, that's how it gets, pushed into the government circuit. But, at this point in time, not too many people are doing that.
So yes, number one is on the accuracy part. As I said, RT-PCR is always a gold standard for detecting any of the parameter. The reason to it is it amplifies the quantity of the signal and reads it. Here, because it's a visual or a phone-based interpretation, it cannot be amplified. So as I said, a positive test by the self-testing kit is 100% positive. You need not to do even a reconfirmation test again after that. While a negative test by such method, if you still have a symptom, you should do a RT-PCR test on the same day. Most of the time, even if it is negative right now, maybe on a second or third day, a self-test also comes positive, because the viral load may not be as enough that to be picked by a self-test, but maybe picked by an RT-PCR test. That is the only difference between these two methodology of testing. At the same time, as you said, we have given empowerment to the people to just take the photo, and the photo interprets and gives you a report in hand to you. This report is also very, very crucial. Number one, it helps government to know the data. But at the same time, for people to have a positive report handy is very, very important. As I said, you will not need not to do any further spending on an RT-PCR test confirmation if a hospitalization or a medical emergency is needed. So this report itself is handy enough for any emergency need. Number two, even if you are having any insurance claim or any claim after this, would need this kind of report with you. So it's more important for people to have it than not to have it. The incentives to not to have is nothing. It's just the more of awareness has to be needed. And I think me and of course Jagannath sir would also, we are encouraging chemists to also train these two people for making sure that the benefits are far, far more than not doing it.
Right, Mr. Shinde, I also want to understand in terms of trends for other medicines consumption, what kind of trends are you seeing shaping up in the chemist chains on a pan-India basis?
You find that because of the awareness and things, now blood pressure, tablet, or kit, or sometimes diabetic and other things, people are having a bit of self-testing. and there's a regularly, then you find that pregnancy kits are now available. So that is also the ladies mostly they demand because they need testing and thing. So this is going on. After testing, you must go to doctor, show him this report, because this primary report may not be that correct sometimes, looking at the patient to patient, it will differ. The right thing is that after, as a chemist, we always tell people, go to right, doctors, get tested.
Right. Mr. Rawal, I want to talk to you a little bit about, you know, some concerns that have been raised by the government, saying that, with more people using self-test kits, that's a concern because not too many people are coming through the official channel and testing out there. So do you think, there's something that, the test manufacturers, the test kit manufacturers can do at source when a consumer buys the test itself to ensure that there is better accountability?
Yeah. So number one, we have so many educative and informative videos. Even on the pack, there is a barcode explaining how to do a test, how to report it. It's hardly 30 to 40 second procedure on the mobile to really do it. So there is a lot of awareness campaign happening from us. We are also educating our pharmacists to make sure that how they will train people when they're selling it. Number two. Number three, but at the same time, I would also like to mention again and again, is a positive number may not be a true indicative always, because there's so many asymptomatic positive people with us around us. Just because they're not tested, they're not counted in. So there is also a huge, gap of positivity, which we are not knowing under the radar because they're just not testing because they're asymptomatic. If you see in US, despite all the, in fact, there's no reporting software in US. It's like if you are positive, you just call and convey. Imagine who will take this pain to really do it if they're found positive. Despite all this, they are ordering 500 million tests to the manufacturer just to rely on self-testing. So that's the power of and importance of such testing. What I feel is a hospitalization count is far more better indicator than the positivity count, because you cannot really count all positivity known to you. So if you, as far as you can test yourself, contain yourself, and the hospitalization is limited, I think that's the biggest success indicator for any government. And if we can rely on this number rather than a positivity number, would be a better indicator. Having said so, positivity is important to know the demography of the situation. And for this, I think people should be encouraged to report themselves. There is no harm. There is a more of an incentive on it.
Right. There has been a shortage of tests in a couple of chemists as well. So how are you addressing that? Are you increasing the kind of manufacturing from your point of view to be able to cater to the kind of demand that you're seeing?
So number one, yes, because of the sudden demand, nobody was prepared, whether it is us or medicine guys or whether it is mask. If the demand increases, people are not that ready anytime. At our end, at my lab, we are touching our full capacity by end of this week. So I think people should not worry. They should have more and more of COVID tests from us by end of this week. Any which ways, we will be on our full capacities. So should not be a concern. That's not a bigger concern. At the same time, we have also enough raw material available with us. We need not to depend upon sourcing activity. It's just the manufacturing. We have to make sure that these are manufactured and converted into finished goods.
But I also want to know, when you talk about full capacity, can you put a number to it in terms of how many tests will be manufactured per day and what kind of outreach will be there on the distribution channel?
So we are current capacity is around 1.5 million tests per day, manufacturing capabilities. In fact, we are prepared to do it almost twice of the capacities if needed most. In terms of raw material, as I rightly said, we have enough raw material available with us for next 2 months of supply for the country, and we can order more if needed. Number three, in terms of supply, luckily we have a very strong pharmacy partners, distribution networks, and all these pharmacies are actually in sync with our logistic chain. So I think that's not a problem. There is a great association of pharmacies across India. They are well networked, and the reach wise almost they're everywhere. So along with that, there is an online network as well, where people can just order it and it can be delivered on the same or next day with them.
Right. One question before I let you go on, the way forward on how to improve the accuracy of these tests. What is MyLab doing to improve the kind of the quality, the kind of accuracy, and what kind of plans do you have for the rest of this year?
So there are three tests which we are again launching one by one. First test is a far more developed version of a home testing kit, but it's a little small version dependent, maybe a small of a mobile phone, three of a mobile phone at a time, where you will not be only able to detect but also quantitate the virus. The current test is already approved by government to us. We are working on the machinery and all those parts. Number two, we are developing a simple RT-PCR test, as simple as a rapid test, without lab, without pipette. It's a point of care in a throughput of maybe 35-40 minutes. That should come in a month or so from us. And also, we are working on a far more specific, sensitive, and I'll say speedy test, maybe in a report in a 2 minutes or so, as good as the RT-PCR test. Such test should be launched by MyLab in 3 months or so. So there's a great innovation happening. I think if you come and visit our lab, you would see what kind of work we are doing. But for all these products are for the first time in the world, not only in India. And this is an innovation from MyLab we give to the people.
Right. Mr. Shinde, a final question before I let you go on, you know, what are chemists and all the partners that you're working with doing at this point in time to reach out to manufacturers to ensure that you all have adequate supply of tests when required by the people at this point?
See, whenever such a new thing, new solution comes, generally manufacturer, we, as we rightly, Mr. Rawal said, we have a huge network with the manufacturer also, because there are the huge number of people working, doing business in your diagnostic and surgical and other thing. So automatically through them, whenever new product comes in the market, within no time, we come to know. And then, as you rightly said, we through our retail, we make it available to people. And it's a good part of my lab, because they are making a very rapid test in RT-PCR also. The consumer will get, or the patient will get a fast treatment because of this. And I think my lab, whatever discoveries they are making, it'll help particularly the consumer or mankind, all the mankind of India and also abroad. I think it's a good move, and I appreciate the work of Rawalji or my lab in this field of discovery of diagnostic solutions or kit. I appreciate that, and definitely we will cooperate them if they recommend for the distribution of such kit to a people within no time or with zero time. So that is a good move, and I appreciate that.
All right. On that note, gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us today. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so much for your time.